a light shines through, exposing the frauds for who they are. Every time he creates, introducing the boldest man on the net.
How do you reconcile this biblical declaration in Acts that says the Samaritans believed and were also baptized in water, but had yet to receive the Holy Spirit, with prosperity preachers' declaration today that say belief and water baptism alone is receipt of the Holy Spirit? How do you reconcile this biblical declaration in Acts that says the Samaritans believed and were also baptized in water, but had yet to receive the Holy Spirit, with today's declaration by prosperity preachers that says belief in water baptism alone is receipt of the Holy Spirit? Let me put it another way. How do you reconcile what is expressly stated in Acts that belief alone and water baptism is not receipt of the Holy Spirit with modern day prosperity preachers who say belief and water baptism alone is receipt of the Holy Spirit? How do you reconcile what is expressly stated in Acts that belief alone and water baptism is not receipt of the Holy Spirit with modern day prosperity preachers who say belief in water baptism alone is receipt of the Holy Spirit?
LeGrant Anthony on the Place to Be Blog Talk Radio Show.
Come on, let's rock. Everybody, come on, put your hand out there. Make some noise. Pipe it up.
If Peter had accepted Simon's offer of a tithe of money for preaching the gospel of Christ, prosperity preachers today would declare they have biblical proof to justify their mandatory New Covenant 10% tithe of money. This would be the most quoted scripture in the Bible for prosperity preachers. However, Peter did not accept Simon's offer of a tithe of money for preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. This shows that a tithe of money for preaching the gospel of Jesus was not an acceptable practice, but on the contrary, an abomination.
Hold on, my brother, don't give up.
Hold on, my sister.
Hold on, my sister, just look up.
There's a master plan. There is a master plan in store for you. If you just make it through, God's gonna really blow your mind. He's gonna make it worth your time.
For all the trouble.
Taking money for preaching the gospel of Christ was considered by Peter a detestable sin. Peter's refusal to accept Simon's offer of a tithe of money for preaching the gospel of Christ does not justify a mandatory 10% New Covenant tithe, but rather clearly condemns the practice of collecting a mandatory 10% tithe of money practiced by prosperity preachers. Peter's refusal to accept Simon's offer of a tithe of money for preaching the gospel of Christ does not justify a mandatory 10% New Covenant tithe, but rather clearly condemns the practice of collecting a mandatory 10% tithe of money practiced by prosperity preachers. How did Peter respond to Simon's offer of a tithe of money for preaching the gospel of Christ? In Acts verse 20, Peter says, quote, "But Peter said unto him, Thou money perisheth with thee, because thou hast thought that the gift of God may be purchased with money."
Let's get twice.
The best is yet to come.
Hold on.
Hold on, my brother, don't give up. Hold on, my sister, just look up. There is a master plan in store for you. If you just make it through.
He's gonna make it.
He's gonna make it.
Christians today have been taught by prosperity preachers that the gifts of God can be purchased with money. Men like Creflo Dollar have bewitched Christians in College Park, Georgia, that all the gifts of God and all the promises of God cannot be obtained without the payment of a monetary tithe of money. Scripture says dollars decoration is an abomination. Dollars insidious lust for money and fraudulent sale of God's promises for money cannot be denied.
I'm telling you that your tithe is your covenant connector. I'm telling you that all the promises that God ever gave you, you cannot get them without being connected to them with the tithe. I'm telling you the only way you're going to get hooked up to healing is through the tithe. I'm telling you the only way you're going to get hooked up to prosperity, deliverance, or any promise in the Word of God is through the tithe.
According to Scripture, Dollar and other prosperity preachers are teaching a gospel of wickedness.
Thy money perish with thee, because thou hast thought that the gift of God may be purchased with money. Thou hast neither part nor lot in this matter, for thy heart is not right in the sight of God. Repent therefore of this thy wickedness, and pray God, if perhaps the thought of thine heart may be forgiven thee.